Welcome to Early Gossip's Inspired Flow. Today we're going to bring up some powerful points from Tony Robbins. And he was with his wife Sage, and he was speaking to a guy called Michael, or Mickey. And you can go to his podcast, Tony Robbins, and listen to the whole class. I'm not going to repeat what he said, but the latest one that's just come in this week. This is the week of end of November, so we are holding about being happy Hanukkah. We want to get ready for Hanukkah, and we want to be happy. How do we get happy? And the way that I visualize happiness is to do with choosing. This is the big thing. Besimcha is osis machshava. So it's actually funny, because the way they're explaining it is you shouldn't be in your mind, but it's with your mind you choose to not be in your mind, to not be stuck in your voices and ego and all the things that hold a person back. And what they said is you have to let go and flow. This is like the whole podcast, what I'm talking about over here, Inspired Flow, is being able to let go and experience the flow. This is a powerful tool in life, and to get to the level where you can let go and flow takes a lot of work. So it's not like some magic button. You have to actually do the hard work, or whatever field you're in, whatever your expertise, whatever your talent is, whatever the people around you, the relationships you're building, to get to the point where you can flow in those workspaces, in those relationships, and all the different things you're setting out to achieve, you have to be able to let go. So this is something which, obviously, in a big way, we're all aiming for together. To be able to experience what the flow is in your field. Obviously it means you're at your most effective and you're totally like gelling with what's required. Like example with Robbins, you see when he does his big meetings in the I'm Not Your Guru, and he does his encounters and helps people through very big issues. You can see that he's a professional, he's at a flow at that, or athletes, or anybody out there who's achieving on a high level, they worked hard. That is just how it has to be. I was listening to Lewis Howes, and he was talking about how he says there's no way forward without hard work. Like, it has to come from really what, and a person has to do the inner work. That's the whole idea we're saying with happiness. You have to choose that moment to really be in that moment, to be letting go on all the different ways we want to control life, and be in that moment and not control life. Let life not be, but let life become part of your experience that you can not get in the way. Like my Rebbe always used to say, why hasn't the Messiah come, you know, the Mashiach? Where is he? So, or she, or whatever it is, the Mashiach, the force of redemption. Why hasn't it come? The concept is because we're in the way, blocking it. So all we have to do, said my Rebbe, is just get out of the way. All of us, we just have to get out of the way in our life, in our daily experience. I would love to have things done a certain way, certain time frame, and it doesn't always work out that way. So what we have to do is get out of that way, so that we can allow the flow how it's supposed to be and when it's supposed to be. And that divine providence will guide everything in a larger force, in a larger way, so we can actually experience life. So this is something which we all have to do, and it can be niggly things. Some people can be challenging that, and you'll be like, well, you're getting in my way now. So part of the thing now is not to get in their way, to react. Once we learned from Stephen Covey, to be proactive, and that's like the first stage for everything. And it was interesting that, since you mentioned that, I put out a concept called the 10 Habits of Highly Effective Yous. You can Google it, 10 Habits of Truly Effective Yous. There we go, truly, not highly, truly effective yous. And it was like, obviously in reference to Stephen Covey's 7 Habits and his 8th Habit, I took it to the 10 Habits. And if you go to Gedalia Fence, he's actually talking about it in his SoundCloud and his Power Class, Breath of Power Class. You can go there and see that, you know, we're talking the same kind of thing. It's all mysticism, it all has a deep framework of foundation and pattern of understanding, of way of thinking, a way of being that helps a person succeed. So I recommend all those things, and I was happy that he put out another class. Daddy Fenster didn't quote me because maybe he came to realization himself. Either way, once again, let me ego get out of the way. We're all here to just enter that flow and succeed, and that is the key to make the right decisions to have a happy life. So this is going to be the Inspired Happy Flow Get Out of the Way class. Okay, have a good one. Have a great day. Can't wait to hear yours.